El censo, que ustedes saben, lleva información bastante precisa y también la investigación que realiza Pew Research Center como fuentes de datos que ustedes quizás quieran consultar. Entonces, sabemos que el número se acerca a los 60 millones de personas de origen hispano o latino en los Estados Unidos, estamos muy cerca de ese número, y representa un 18% de la población total. La proyección es que va a ser 24% de la población para el año 2060.
Although Mexico continues to be the most frequent country of origin for most of this population, with 62%, we have a growing diversity, and we think that that diversity will continue to grow, which will have a direct impact on the varieties of Spanish that we will start hearing in the United States, because we only have the just Spanish-English contact, we'll have these multiple Spanish varieties converging and creating new forms. So I think that it's an exciting time to be doing sociolinguistic research in here, if you are interested in this area. And finally, this is not that nice information, but I think that it's also relevant to really understand the communities of our students. 22% of the Hispanic households are below the poverty level, and they have a direct impact on education, job opportunities, and just well-being. I think that this is something that we need to keep in mind every time that we work with heritage learners. And we have some data here distributed about, the different places, the metroplexes where we have a lot of people living that are Hispanic. You can find different areas. And interesting enough, I'm marketing green. My area, which is next to Dallas, has seen a growth of more than 118% of the Hispanic population the last 5 years. So there is an explosion of new Hispanics living in North Texas. And here you have Hispanic by origin also from the 2016-2017 data. And still, Mexico continues to be high, but there is a decrease in immigration from Mexico, and there is an increase from Central America. So that's a change that is ongoing. See, what you have here, like a nice distribution. So if you have a class with, let's say, 20 students, you will have probably 15 students, 16 that are with Mexican background, but you have another 5 or 6 that are coming from here.